Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler, and helping me call this one is Kirk Herbstreit. And Aaron Andrews also joins us on the sidelines. Welcome to College Football, brought to you by EA Sports on ESPN. Today's game is between
the Virginia Tech Hokies and the Duke Blue Devils. We're in Durham, North Carolina, where the air is full of football frenzy.
It's early in the season, but we've got a great battle here in the ACC Coastal Division. For Duke, a really versatile linebacker will be making life tough for them.
He could really shut down the run game today. They don't feature a particularly explosive back on the other side.
Kickoff is just ahead, but first let's take you down for the coin toss. We'd like to take this time to let you know that our game is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Reed from the five. Gets to about the 24-yard line. The first drive of the game about to get underway as the quarterback leads his team out. The offense will start at the 24. First down, 10 to go. They give to the tailback. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line.
Offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
From their own 36-yard line, first down. Oh, he got nailed on that one. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
From their own 46-yard line, second down. Back to pass. Caught by the tight end, past the marker. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 4-yard completion.
Nothing special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
Down, 10 to go. Ball on the 50-yard line. Penalty. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Dead ball. Won't start on the offense. Still first down.
First and 15 now after the penalty. They work the right side and there is nothing going there. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
That was the junior linebacker who'll get credit with the tackle there.
From their own 46-yard line, second down.
Oh,
Takes the handoff inside and stopped immediately. 3 yards there on the play.
That makes it 3rd and 11.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. Looking to throw. Knocked down, incomplete.
I thought they did a good job of reading the play and positioning themselves well to break up the pass.
It's 4th down. Looks like they're going to punt it away here. Didn't get all of that one. On the return, and he fumbles the ball.
How about that? They get the ball right back. Now let's see if they can take advantage of it.
Good field position here. They'll start this drive inside their opponent's territory. Outside after a nice pickup. Young picks up 5 with the carry.
That makes it 2nd and 6.
It's 2nd down, 6 to go. Ball on the 21. Young sweeps right. He's taken down around the 20-yard line. He picks up a yard at best on the toss. So it's 3rd down now, and they're going to need about 4. Give to the tailback. Tackle made at the 20. They'll be short of the 1st down after that unsuccessful running play.
Nice job here by the defense of holding firm and forcing a 4th down.
4th down, and the kicking team is on to try this 37-yard field goal. This to try to put his team up by a field goal. And it's good. Warren is lined up to kick this one off. Short kickoff. Made the 30-yard line. Let's see how the offense rebounds after fumbling on their last possession. The offense will take over at the 30. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And they make the stop at the 46-yard line. So the run goes for a big 1st down.
The offensive line opened up some nice lanes to run through as well. Nice play.
It's 1st and 10. They'll go with the run once again. He takes it right side for a good game. 7 yards there.
That'll bring up 2nd and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on 2nd down. The halfback with a carry. Can't wrap him up, and the counter is good enough for the first.
Yeah, the offensive line did a good job of selling that play on that one, and the halfback was aware of that 1st down line and got the conversion.
We've got a 1st and 10, ball on the 44. Back to pass. He's taken down at the 30.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
from the 30-yard line. First down. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
He showed you some of his natural athletic ability following the play and making a really quick stab to knock away the pass.
From the 30-yard line, second down. Denman drops back. Great concentration. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
First and 10. For the first time today, we'll get to see how this defense responds when they're backed up into the red zone. Here's a counter, and he's got open field in front of him. He's hit and got away. A 9-yard pickup by the tailback on the counter play.
That brings up second and one.
Here's the 8th play of the series. It's second down. Carries, and he will score.
Things can get pretty fierce in this territory, but they look totally in control there. Nice play to take the 3-point lead here early in the first quarter. The question now is if they can build off this momentum later in the game.
He makes the PAT. Let's take a glance at the drive summary. Set to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 6. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. We're set to get restarted as the offense looks to build on the success of their field goal on the last drive.
And even though these guys are losing, they showed in their last drive that they can score, and they need to continue to be productive with this drive.
They'll get the ball here at the 26-yard line. It's first and 10. Tackle made at the 25-yard line.
Well, he's known for locking down receivers, but that doesn't mean he won't come up and lay the lumber on the ball carrier.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, our score, Duke 7, Virginia Tech 3. Second down and 11. Ball on the 25-yard line. Young, again, and they get nice yardage on that run. Young gained 7 yards on that play.
That'll bring up 34.
From their own 32-yard line, third down. Garcia steps back to pass. Long ball, right side. Dropped. Miranda was the intended target on the play. That's going to bring up fourth down.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Fourth down. Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away.
There's a little laundry on the field, and we'll find out whose it is.
Holding on the receiving team.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
First and 10. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Denman adjusts the play at the line. He drops back. He got hit hard.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
We've got a first and 10. Duke holds a 4-point lead. Looking long to the right. Incomplete.
You definitely want to give your receiver some room to run under the ball, but not that much.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 37. Denman, back to pass. Got some open field. Brought down around the 16-yard line.
The linebacker here does a good job with his instincts of getting in the path of the receiver. Boy, what a great play.
From the 16-yard line, first down. Young takes the give. Runs outside for a nice gain. Young gains around 6 yards on the run. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. It's a direct snap. And he's taken down right around the 12-yard line.
More plays like this, and the coaching staff is going to need to change up the blocking scheme. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
It's third down from the 11-yard line. They snap it to the back. And down he goes at the 16-yard line.
I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he stops before he even gets going.
On the field, they'll try for three. This will be a 33-yard field goal attempt. And he's got it. Virginia Tech lines up for the kickoff. Short kickoff. Smith fields it at the 22. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Straight in the middle, and he meets the defense. A one-yard gain on the play.
The defense called the blitz at the right time, and they were able to come after the running back before he went for big yards.
From their own 33-yard line, second down.
Expect your guy to come down with it every time. The defense is going to jump on one of those and take it the other way.
Duke is up one. Denman to the air on first down. And he's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back to pass.
From the 32-yard line, it's first down. Duke with a one-point lead. They'll bring him down at about the 19-yard line.
Besides going deep on the fade, the slant route is probably the most commonly run route against man coverage. If the receiver gets a good inside release, it'll be a new set of downs every time.
Sets them up with a first and goal.
Nice throw to hit the out route against man coverage for a first down.
Duke, first down here, trying to make it a two-score game. Duke, up a point. Taken down in the backfield.
The defense just met the blockers head-on and drove them back straight into the runner.
That brings up second and goal.
Second down. There's only 8 yards between the ball and the end zone. Gives it up the gut. Touchdown, Duke! And for McLaurin, he now has 2 touchdowns on the ground today.
This young man is no stranger to the end zone. That's 2 rushing scores for him on the day, and you have to love the way he's been running the ball all game.
Converts the extra point. And now we take a look at the drive summary. Duke to kick. White from the 6. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. 3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 19. Drops back on first down. Caught. Tackle at about the 39-yard line. The offense calls a timeout. First and 10.
Garcia drops back on first down.
It's picked off.
Throws this one away. The pressure up front is really what did it. The coverage was good, and maybe it confused him. But it was the heat that forced the bad throw.
This is a dangerous situation, backed up against their goal line. Ball on the two. McLaurin on the give. He gets out to about the 14-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
And that'll do it for the first half of play. Our halftime score, Duke 14, Virginia Tech 6.
Virginia Tech is set to kick this ball off, and we're just about set to get the second half started.
Smith fields it at the 26. Gets to about the 37-yard line.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again.
They'll start at the 37-yard line.
Duke up by 8. Takes the handoff inside and stopped immediately. 3-yard gain by the running back.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Second down and 7. He makes the catch and has a first down.
He stood in there that time against the blitz. They were coming after him, but he showed the poise and was able to connect for a big gain.
First down, 10 to go. McLaurin runs a counter. Nice run to the left there. The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counter play.
That makes it 2nd and 2.
There you go. 2nd and 2. Ball on the 26. Yard gain on the run for the tailback there.
That's another rush from this halfback. This time he does a great job of finding the opening in the defense and picking up a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Duke holds an 8-point advantage. Four.
Somehow gets the ball away.
A lot of times you don't have time to react on a pass that is thrown into the end zone. So that was a very good job to get his hand in the way to knock the ball away.
From the 20-yard line, second down. Duke is up by 8. McLaurin takes it left. Taken down as he works the left for a nice gain. A gain of 6.
That'll bring up 34.
It's third down, 4 to go. Ball on the 14. They got 6 the last time they were inside the 20. Let's see what they do here. They keep it on the ground, and a great tackle right there.
Great job here in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Duke can make this a 2-possession game with this field goal. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Duke gets set to kick this one away. From the 5-yard line. Gets to about the 24-yard line. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. They'll get the ball here at the 24-yard line. First and 10. Nice run, and he's brought down. Green gets about 4 yards on the play.
That makes it second and 6.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Off, and he's met immediately. That'll be a gain of 3 yards.
It's a good call here by the defense. They were able to get some good penetration on the run blitz and kept the gain pretty minimal.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They go to the ground and he stops short. Couldn't get that additional yard he needed to keep the drive moving.
No, he was trying to muscle his way past those big guys, but they stood their ground.
Harris back deep to return. It's away, short punt. Brought down at the 38-yard line. The offense gets set to take the field. Last time out, they stuck it between the uprights for 3.
That was great offensive production. Everything really came together for them on that last drive.
They'll start this drive at the 38. It's the tailback. And down he goes to the 38-yard line. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
One thing about this linebacker over the years that separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice tackle by the senior.
From their own 38-yard line,
Second down. Fires to his receiver, first down.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. McLaurin gets the ball. Has some daylight. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 18-yard line. An amazing run. This kid was moving.
Man, no kidding. This guy can fly.
We've got a first and 10, ball on the 18-yard line. The defense looks confident as they held them to a field goal on their last red zone trip. Runs it and tackled in the backfield.
I'm not sure if they thought about that one too much or not, but either way, the result wasn't very good.
That's three down and one to go. Our score is 17-6. Second and long. I don't really know what this one's for. Let's find out.
Holding on the offense.
Holding penalties can really kill momentum. But sometimes, if you don't hold, your quarterback can take a pretty good shot.
It's second down and a long way to go. Ball on the 34. Back. Here he goes. And he's brought down at the 9-yard line. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
Duke looks to take a commanding 3-score lead here. Get it again. Nice run up the middle. McLaurin picks up about 7 yards on the run.
That brings up second and goal.
It's second and goal. He's in. touchdown. And for McLaurin, his good day just became a great day with his third touchdown.
Until they can figure out how to slow him down, it's going to be very tough for them to get back into this game.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. That score leads us to our drive summary. Duke is lining up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the six. Makes it to the 22-yard line. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. They'll take over at the 22-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Swings it out left to the halfback.
He lost the ball. A lot of guys in the defensive backfield are ball hawks, and the safety showed it there by pouncing on the football.
Fires to the wideout, first down.
There was good pressure coming in, but he stood his ground and found his teammate for a nice game.
First and goal from the three. They're knocking on the door. Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown. I don't expect this one to be any different. Denman, options out, and no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds.
They got a little sloppy here with their ball handling. It's a good thing they were near the sideline. Otherwise, the defense could have pounced on that football.
It's second down. 6 yards stand between them and 6 points. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. It's the tailback. He gets out to about the 6-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That makes it 30 goal.
The ball's on the 6-yard line, and we've got third and goal. They go with a run, and they stopped him. He barely got it past the line of scrimmage that time.
That brings up fourth and goal.
It's fourth down, and they'll line up for the short field goal. This one from 22. And he's got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. White takes it at the 8. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. Garcia back to throw.
He really wanted that ball, didn't he, Kirk?
Now, you can't teach hustle like that. The linebacker was determined to get the ball there, and he did.
Gets it out to his receiver, and he can't hang on.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
From the 20-yard line, it's second down. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That last pass got him only a yard.
Nice grab there by the tailback to at least move the ball forward for some positive yards.
From the 19-yard line, third down. They're in the red zone where last time they came away with only a field goal. Pass is tipped away.
Anytime you can prevent a third down conversion, you're doing something right. Solid coverage.
And he's got it. Wade is lined up to kick this one off. And he'll return this one from the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. And now we'll see the offense come out of the field for their next possession. They'll set up shop at the 23. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. He's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 32. And they'll go with a no huddle.
At the 32-yard line. That brings up second and one.
Garcia drops back. Complete. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on.
Holding on the offense.
Well, if you want to ruin a drive, just grab a hold of a defender's jersey.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. Garcia, back to pass. Out of bounds at the 45. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Caught, and he's hit immediately. And it looks like they're going to go no huddle here.
Makes it second and 10.
Garcia hasn't missed yet. Catches it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
You know, having a playmaker tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
Drops back on first down. And it's the senior. And they make the stop at around the 28-yard line. They must have seen something in the defense because that was the exact same play as the one they ran before.
Exactly the same play. The defense better make some adjustments because right now there's a mismatch that the offense has taken advantage of.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
Garcia drops back on first down. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. He's got the corner. He's got the two. And now we're going to take a look at the drive summary. The offense will take over at the 35. Gives it off. And he's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask on the defense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. We've got a first and 10. The kicker got him 3 points in that last red zone visit. Let's see if they can come away with six this time. Gets it on the counter, got room. Bounces off a would-be tackler. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Duke is about to extend the lead to 3 scores. They're crowding the line. Looking for Peter. Found it. Touchdown. And for McLaurin, he scores yet again. That makes it 4 touchdowns.
We wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
And he adds the extra point. But here's the drive summary to recap what just happened. Duke to kick. Gathered in at the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll start at the 20. Garcia to the air on first down. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
Garcia drops back on first down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. lets it fly. And he's brought down at the 26-yard line.
That's just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down.
And that one's incomplete.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed it.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26. Give to the tailback. Makes his way out to about the 15. And the tailback broke that one for a very nice gain.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
So their last red zone visit resulted in a touchdown. Let's see if the defense can hold them this time. What a play, and that is first and goal. They're really putting a nice drive together right now.
And it seems right now this defense is having a hard time guessing what the offense is up to.
First and goal from the 3. Let's see if they can muscle this one in. They're crowding the line. Green on the run. Tackle made around the 2-yard line. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, Duke 37, Virginia Tech 14.